are class 12. Today I am here to share with you second unit of the your syllabus, that is electrical potential and capacitance. In this unit, the important points or important topics which I will share with you today are: number 1, electric potential. What is electric potential? Number 2, electric potential difference. What is the meaning of electric potential difference? Number 3, expression for electric potential due to isolated point charge body. Number 4, expression for electric potential due to system of charges. Number 5, relation between intensity and potential. So first topic of discussion today is electric potential. It refers how much body is electrified. Electric potential means how much body is electrified, how much electrical properties body can show. It is represented by capital V. The symbol of electric potential is capital V. It is a scalar quantity, and numerically defined as work done per unit charge. Work done per unit charge. This is the numerical definition of electric potential. That is, potential is equal to W by Q. What is Q? Charge which is shifted from infinity to any point inside the field. And what is W? Amount of work done. In theoretical form, it is can be defined as the amount of work done to bring unit charge body from infinity to any point inside electric field region of source charge body. In the first unit, we shared with you what is source charge body. Charge body responsible to create its electric field region. What is test charge body? Such type of charge body which is hypothetical, consists of positive nature and of unit magnitude charge. So this is the theoretical definition of electric potential. It is the definition numerically, and meaning of electric potential is how much body is electrified. Now, since electric potential is the ratio of work done and charge, unit of electric potential will be either joule per coulomb. Joule per coulomb is known as volt. Either erg per stat coulomb. This is called ab volt. This is Amperes unit, joule per coulomb or volt, and this is CGS unit, erg per stat coulomb or ABF volt. What is the electric potential difference and what is the meaning of it? For it, suppose we have taken a source charge body of charge Q, and this is its electric field region. We discuss what is the meaning of electric region in first chapter. We know every charge body consists of its electric field region nearly up to infinite distance. So if we assume a point M here, definitely this point M is kept at infinity. So let at this point we have placed experimental charge body Q0, because test charge body in real life we don't have.
We are moving this experimental charge body inside the electric field region up to let point A. Keep in mind, when we are shifting the charge body from infinity to point A, charge body should perform constant velocity motion. Means the force which will experience the charge body in outward direction, same amount of force we have to apply on the charge body in inward direction to move the charge body. Let move on moving the charge body from Q naught to A, work done is VWA. This much work is done. So if WA amount of work is done to move the charge body of charge Q naught, what will be the work done to move unit charge body? That will be W by Q naught, and this will be potential at A according to definition. Another charge body, same nature, magnitude, same nature, is kept at M and shifted up to point B. Definitely, since it is shifted up to more distance, different work will be done in this case. Let that work be W. So, if WB work is done to move the charge body of charge Q naught from infinity to B, so potential at B will be WB by Q naught. Since WA and WB are not equal, it means potential at A and potential at B are also not equal. It means inside the electric field region, different points consist of different value of electric potential. So if here potential is having some other value, here potential is having some other value, it means between these two points there is difference of potential, and that is called electric potential difference. So electric potential difference will be difference of potential between any two points inside electric field region. Now if we calculate mathematically the value of WA and WB, we will find that WB is more than WA. So since WB is more than WA, it means VB will be more than VA. So the value of electric potential difference will be VB minus VF, high potential value minus lower potential value. That is WB by Q naught minus WA by Q naught. That is VB minus VA, which is electric potential difference, is equal to WB minus WA by Q naught. If WA is the work done to move the charge body from infinity to A, and WB is the work done to move the charge body from infinity to B, then how much work will be done to move the charge body from A to B? That will be WB minus WA. So WB minus WA is called work done to move the charge body from A to B. And this is the expression to find electric potential difference. And this point is very important to know. Suppose we have two points M and N inside electric field region, and we want to know Vm minus Vn. So as when we are finding VB minus VA, we are writing WB minus WA. We work done to move the charge body from A to B. Sorry. It will be VB minus VA. So what is VM minus VN? Work done to move the charge from N to N upon Q naught. Suppose we have two points C and D, and we want to know what is the value of BC minus BD. We will find work done to move the charge from D to C upon Q naught. This is how we find the electric potential difference. the unit of electric potential difference will be same as that of electric potential because it is also the ratio of Bogdan and charge. Next is expression for electric potential due to isolated point charge body. Now here one point, always remember the value of potential. Since potential is a scalar quantity, so potential value may be negative, may be positive. If you have source charge of negative nature, if we have a source charge of negative nature, then work done will be by the source charge to move the external charge body. In that case, potential will have negative sign. If source charge is of positive nature, then work will be done by external agency to move the charge. In that case, potential will be taken with positive sign. So when we will take potential with negative sign? When source charge is of negative nature, the charge responsible to create electric field is having, if negative nature, potential will be negative. And when we will take potential positive? When source charge is of positive nature. These two points you should keep in the mind always. Now next is expression for the electric potential. This expression is similar to the class 11th expression of gravitational potential. Suppose we have a source charge capital Q. It is its electric field region. At point M, we have placed experimental charge Q naught at infinity. Till we are moving charge up to this distance, no work will be done because no force is acting opposite to it, so no force we have to apply on it. But as this experimental charge is reached at A, whose distance from source charge is x, it will experience force here. So we have to push the charge inward, means we have to do some work. Let by applying this amount of force in on the charge body, it is shifted to very small distance dx up to point B. If charge body is shifted from A to B by very small distance dx, the amount of work done will be also very small, that is force into displacement. Now since here force is acting outward, displacement is inward, so we will write it as f dx into cos 90, that is minus f dx. What is f? Force between charge body and source charge at distance x, which will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into q naught by x square into dx. This is the small work done. When charge body is shifted from A to B, how much work will be done when charge body will be shifted from M to, let point C, whose distance from source charge is capital R? We are shifting charge body of charge Q naught from M to C. We want to know how much work will be done. This is the small work done to move the charge from A to B. So comparison to this, when charge body will be shifted from M to C, more work will be done. So we use integration. So total work done to move the charge from M to C will be integration of small work done, integration of minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into q naught upon x square into dx. Since we are integrating here with respect to x, so we put the limit of x here. When source experimental charge is here, x is infinite. When experimental charge will be here, x will become r. So limit will be from infinity to r. Take constant term outside. x to the power minus 2 dx. Integration will be x to the power minus 1 upon minus 1. When we put the limit, we take first minus 1 outside, it will become positive 1 by x. That is what then will be finally 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into q naught by r. X will become r. This much work is done to move the experimental charge body from infinity to C. So, potential at C, according to definition, potential should be work done upon charge. Now, work done is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q into q naught by r, charge is q naught. So, finally, expression for potential at any point due to isolated point charge body will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. What was the expression for intensity? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. So, potential varies inversely with single power of distance, and intensity was varying inversely with square of the distance. Now, here says potential is scalar quantity, and this q is the charge associated with source charge body. So if source charge body is having positive value, this q will be positive. If source charge body is having negative value, this q will be negative. So accordingly, potential will become positive or negative. This is the expression for the electric potential at any point due to isolated point charge body. Next is expression for electric potential due to system of charges. If we have so many charge bodies present at different places, point A, point B, point C, point D, and we want to know potential at any point due to other, let here charge body charge Q1, here charge body charge minus Q2, here charge body charge Q3, here charge body charge minus Q4. This distance is R12, this distance is R13, this distance is R14, and we want to know potential at A. Potential at A, there will be three potentials here. One will be developed by charge body present at B, one will be developed by charge body present at C, one will be developed by charge body present at D. And as we discussed the formula just now, to find potential, we should know charge body, source charge body, nature and magnitude, as well as distance, both are given. And since it is scalar quantity, so we will not think where is the direction of potential, as we were thinking about the intensity, because here if we guess intensity, we have to think where intensity will act. Then accordingly, algebraic, we will see the vector sum. Here since this is vector scalar quantity, so we will go for scalar sum. Potential at A due to B plus potential at A due to C plus potential at A due to D. Don't think what is the direction, because it is a scalar quantity, it will have only magnitude. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge at B is minus Q2, and distance between them is R12. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge at C is plus Q3, and distance between them is R13. Plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge at D is minus Q4, distance is R14. In all the parameters, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught is common. You will get minus Q2 by R12 plus Q3 by R13 minus Q4 upon R14. This is the net potential at A. Now, if in the question these distances are not given, position vector of these points are given, then using the class 11 vector method, by using the triangle law, we will find first these distances, then we put here. This is how we find the potential due to system of charges at any point. Next is relation between intensity and potential. Suppose it is the direction of intensity at any region, and we have two points A and B. Charge body of charge Q naught is kept at A. In this direction, it will experience force Q naught into E, which is Lorentz force. If we are shifting the charge body from A to B, let this distance is dr. Amount of work done to move the charge body from A to B will be equal to force dot displacement vector, that is Q naught into E into dr into cos of 180 degree, because force and displacement both are acting just opposite to each other. That is minus Q naught into E into dr. This is the value of potential work done to move the charge body from A to B. And as we know, work done to move the charge body from A to B will be Vb minus, or we can write it as work done to move the charge body from A to B upon Q naught is equal to minus E into dr. Now, work done to move the charge body from A to B upon Q naught, according to the concept of electric potential difference, should be Vb minus Va. It implies that E is equal to minus times Vb minus Va by dr. If Vb minus Va is represented by dv, then E is equal to minus dv by dr. Here dv is called potential difference. This is the relation between intensity and potential. What is the meaning of it? Negative gradient of electric potential will be intensity. Gradient means differentiation with respect to distance. When we differentiate potential with respect to distance and put minus sign here, we get intensity. Now, if the same formula we write as dv is equal to minus edr, implies that v is equal to minus integration of edr, integrating both the sides. So this is the formula which we use when potential is given, intensity is to be calculated, and this is the formula which we use when intensity is given and potential is to be calculated. Negative sign of integration of intensity with respect to distance will be potential, and negative gradient of potential with respect to distance will be intensity. These are the two relations from where we can convert intensity into potential or potential into intensity. Here it is very important point to understand why negative sign is coming. Here negative sign indicate that in the direction of intensity, potential decreases always. This is key point. What negative sign is showing? In the direction of intensity, potential is decreasing. Means if in this picture intensity is acting from my left side to right side, so potential at B will be more than potential at A. This is the meaning of negative sign. Always remember, if intensity direction is given, automatically you have to assume that in that direction if you move, potential keeps on decreasing. So this is the meaning of negative sign. If we don't take negative sign, then we get only magnitude. This will give the magnitude of intensity. If we put minus sign, it will give magnitude with direction, because intensity is a vector quantity.
So this is all about the today's topics which we have discussed, which we want to discuss with you, dear students. Next topics related with this unit will be discussed in my next video lecture. Please do like, share and subscribe my video channel if you have not subscribed yet. Thank you.